After completing this lesson, you should be able to identify interface layouts that can be understood by users who rely on keyboard navigation, identify guidelines to make grids accessible, provide a text equivalent for images, charts, and other graphical content, and specify accessibility text for various screen components. Users with various types of disabilities rely predominantly on keyboard navigation to move through each element on a screen. The WCAG states that, with some exceptions, all elements, including page navigation and UI components, should be navigable via keyboard. You may have heard the term tab order. That refers to the order in which assistive devices, such as screen readers, process information displayed on a screen. When a user relies on keyboard navigation, they typically tap a designated key. It could be the tab key, the space bar, or some other designated key to move from one element to another on a screen. An assistive device reads aloud all the available information about each element. This is where the tooltips, instructions, and accessibility text that you've written to help the user comes into play. Screen readers typically read a page from top to bottom and from left to right. This is important to keep in mind as you design forms and other screens. The tab order for a column layout is top to bottom through the first column, then top to bottom through the second column. As an example, this column layout would be read as first name, street address, state province, and zip postal code. Most users likely expect last name to immediately follow first name and the apartment number to immediately follow the street address. An alternative accessible layout would look like this side-by-side layout, where the tab order is left to right. In this example, the screen reader would announce first name, then last name, then street address, unit apartment number, and so on. A WCAG requirement for keyboard navigation is that when an element has keyboard focus, there is a visual indication for users to know which element currently has focus. The good news here is you don't need to do extra work. All Appian interface elements that can take focus indicate focus visually. Grids are a good way to present tabular data to users who rely on assistive technology. However, it's important to design grids so that when users navigate to a cell, both the column header and corresponding row header value are announced by screen readers. Otherwise, it's easy for users to be confused as to their location in a grid. First, be sure to use the Appian grid component to create the grid. Do not create a fake grid using columns or other components, or else accessibility features will not be available. When designing a grid, create column headers for all columns. If for some reason that's not feasible, add a help tooltip to explain the column headings to the user. Secondly, specify the grid row header parameter. Screen readers will announce the value of each row header when navigating to other cells within that row. Together with the column heading, this grid configuration achieves the goal of keeping the user oriented to their current location in a grid. You can also write an explanation of the grid's purpose using the accessibility text parameter. Applications use a variety of visual elements to convey information to users. However, those with visual impairments will look for a text equivalent for images, charts, and other graphical content. What does this mean to you? First, any place there is an image or icon, use alternative text to specify the text equivalent. This should be a description that tells the user the content of the image and what it's used for. Don't put a file name here. In this example, the accessibility text explains the photo is of the vehicle that is part of the current record. The user can get the information conveyed by the image, such as the model, make, and color, from the record fields. As for charts, the text equivalent would be to provide a read-only grid that displays the same data that is graphed in the chart. In the next lesson, we'll talk about making charts themselves accessible. The accessibility text attribute is provided for many Appian components to help assistive technologies convey contextual information about a component. Use this attribute to provide supplemental information that is not otherwise available to the user to help them understand and interact with the application. Accessibility text will not be visible on the screen, but will be available to the screen reader users. Here we have a form with two boxes for repair site and billing addresses. When completing this form using a screen reader, the user may be confused to hear name, street, address, city, and so on repeated twice. We can add accessibility text to distinguish the repair site and billing fields. In this lesson, you learned about design layouts that can be understood by those who predominantly use keyboard navigation. You saw how to configure grids to make them accessible. It's also necessary to provide a text equivalent for images, charts, and other graphical content so that all users understand the content and purpose of elements they cannot see. You should specify accessibility text when adding various Appian components to help assistive technologies convey contextual information about each component.